In today's video, we'll talk about how one client handled the legal uncertainty regarding the claims he could make for his new dietary supplement, which happened to involve the arena of brain health, although we could be talking about anything, really, because the legal points that we'll cover here could apply to any dietary supplement you are designing to put on the market or redistribute. Hi, I'm Michael H. Cohen. I'm founding attorney of Cohen Healthcare Law Group. We help healthcare industry clients like you navigate healthcare and FDA legal issues so they can launch or continue to scale their health and wellness product or service. Let's say that John created a dietary supplement that targets brain health. He paid for clinical testing and he found out that the supplement is indeed effective in terms of helping people with brain issues like mild cognitive impairment and other geriatric issues. John would like some legal assistance with what kind of claims he can make for his brain health dietary supplements. He hasn't done the level of proof required for a drug, but he did some testing. John asked our legal team, what requirements must I meet to make any of these types of claims for my brain health dietary supplement? So here, without revealing anything about his company, is, you know, a more generalized response. So there are three requirements you have to meet in the law. So first, the law says that you can make structure function claims if you have substantiation that the claims are truthful and not misleading. You must have the substantiation before you make the claims. Second, you must notify FDA that you are using the claim within 30 days of first marketing your product. And third, the claim must include a mandatory disclaimer that you've seen on all the supplements and that's provided in the law. Now, going back to the first requirement, what are structure function claims according to FDA? According to FDA, structure function claims have historically appeared on the labels of conventional foods and supplements, as well as some drugs. Well, the Dietary Supplement Health and Education Act of 1994 established some special regulatory requirements and procedures for structure function claims and two related types of dietary supplement labeling claims, claims of general well-being and claims related to a nutrient deficiency disease. But structure function claims are the most common, and they can describe the role of a nutrient or dietary ingredient intended to affect the normal structure or function of the human body. For example, calcium builds strong bones. And in addition, they may characterize the means by which a nutrient or dietary ingredient acts to maintain such structure or function. For example, maintains bowel regularity or antioxidants, maintain cell integrity. Now, it may not be possible always to draw a totally bright line between structure function and disease claims. You need to look at the objective evidence in your labeling to assess whether a claim is explicitly or implicitly a prohibited disease claim. For example, a statement may not mention a disease, but it could refer to other things that are more in the structure function line, and that they're very exquisitely laid out by FDA. But it's important that we keep in mind two things. You know, first, the context of the statement, which we get from the information on the label, and all other material is going to be considered. And second, you know, supplements just, they can't have disease claims, even implied, because if they do, then you've got to have pre-market review for FDA, and you have to have approval as a drug, unless there's a health claim, which is a specialized category that we'll talk about in another place on our blog or in a video. Understand that FDA includes 10 different criteria to decide whether you have a disease claim, which is something you can't make for supplements. So there's 10 different ways, and the 10th is a catch-all, so a lot to consider. Now, if you're interested in early read, sometimes we will do a legal strategy session, even for supplements, because we can get a quick sense of the claims and get you some basic orientation. But more typically, we want to review the entire label. Thanks for watching. If you have more questions, check out our blog, cohenhealthcarelaw.com/blog. Click on the contact button to send us a message or book an appointment. We look forward to speaking with you again soon.